Last video, we discussed embedded system introduction with examples, applications, then broad embedded system applications and characteristics of an embedded system. So in this video, we will discuss the classification of embedded system, processor in an embedded system, types and selection of embedded processor. Let's see the first topic, classification of embedded system. So embedded system are classified based on the two factors. The first one based on performance and functional requirements, and second one performance of microcontroller. Based on performance and functional requirements, it is divided into four types. The first one, real-time embedded system. Second one, standalone embedded system. Third one, networked embedded system. And fourth one, mobile embedded system. Similarly, performance of microcontroller, it is again classified into three types. The first one, small scale embedded system. Second one, medium scale embedded system. And last one is sophisticated embedded system. Let's see one by one. The first type, that is real-time embedded system. The real-time embedded system is strictly time-specific, which means that the embedded system provides output in a specified or defined time interval. So these types of embedded system provide fast response in critical situations that offer the importance of time-based task performance and the output generation. So that's why real-time embedded system are used in the defense sector, medical and healthcare sector, and any other industrial applications where production is given more priority in the right time. So this real-time embedded system is further divided into two types. The first one is soft real-time embedded system and second one, hard real-time embedded system. Let's see the first type, that is soft real-time embedded system. The time or deadline for these types of embedded system are not strictly followed if the time limit for the task is passed. That means the system does not give results in a defined time. The result or output will still be accepted. Okay. In case of a hard real-time embedded system, the time or deadline of a task is strictly followed. Task must be completed in between time frame, that is a defined time interval. Okay. Otherwise, the result or output may not be accepted. So here, examples. Traffic light system, then military usage in defense sector, then medical usage in health sector, etc. Then see the second type, that is a standalone embedded system. Standalone embedded system or independent system which can work by themselves. They do not depend on a host system. It takes input in digital or analog form and provide the output. Here examples, MP3 players, then microwave ovens, then calculators, etc. Then third type, that is a networked embedded system. Networked embedded system are connected to a network that can be wired or wireless to provide the output to the connected device. They communicate via a network with an embedded web server. Examples, home security system, then ATM machine, then card swipe machine, etc. Then fourth type, that is mobile embedded system. Mobile embedded system are small and easy to use and requires less resources. They are the most preferred embedded system in probability point of view. That is in probability point of view, mobile embedded systems are also be the best. Here examples, MP3 players, mobile phones, digital cameras. So these are the examples of mobile embedded system. Okay, then second type, that is based on performance and a microcontroller. It is divided into three types. The first one is a small scale, second one medium scale, and third one is a sophisticated embedded system. Let's see the first type, that is a small scale embedded system. Small scale embedded system are designed using 8-bit or 16-bit microcontroller. They can be powered by a battery. Then the processor uses very less limited resources of memory and processing speed. Then mainly this system does not act as an independent system. They act as any component of computer system, but they do not compute and dedicated for a specific task. So this is called a small scale embedded system. Then medium scale embedded system. So medium scale means it is a design using 16-bit microcontroller or 32-bit microcontroller. These medium scale embedded system are faster than small scale embedded system. Here integration of a hardware and a software is a complex in these system. Java, C, C++ or the programming language are used to develop medium scale embedded system. Then different types of software tools like a compiler, debugger, then simulator, etc. are used to develop these type of embedded system. Then third type, that is a sophisticated or complex embedded system. Sophisticated or complex embedded system are designed using multiple 32-bit or 64-bit microcontroller. These systems are developed to perform large-scale complex functions. These systems have high hardware and software complexities. We use both hardware and software components to design final system or hardware product. So this is about classification of embedded system. Let's see this next topic, that is processors in an embedded system. A processor is an embedded, that is a processor is an important unit in the embedded system hardware. It is the heart of the embedded system. The basic concept of microprocessor and microcontroller are most important in an embedded system. So a processor has two essential units. The first one is a program flow control unit and second one execution unit. The control unit has a fetch unit for fetching instruction from the memory. Then the execution unit has a circuits that implement the instruction relating to data transfer operations and data conversion from one form to another form. Then the execution unit includes the arithmetic and logical unit, that is ALU, and also the circuits that execute instructions for a program control task, halt, interrupt, or jump to another set of instructions. Then it can also execute instructions for a call or branch to another program and for a call to a function. Then a processor runs the cycle of fetch and execute. Then instructions defined in the processor instruction set are executed in the sequence that they are fetched from the memory. Then a processor is in the form of an IC chip or in the form of application specific integrated circuit, that is AISC, or system on chip, that is SOC. Then core means a part of the functional circuit on the very large scale integrated chip, that is a very large scale means a VLSI. So this is about processor in an embedded system. Then the next slide shows the types of embedded system, processor or chip. Actually, it is a totally six types of embedded system. The first one, general purpose processor. Second one, second one, application specific instruction set processor. Third one, single purpose processor as additional processor, that is SPP. Fourth one, programmable logic device. Fifth one, application specific system processor. Last one, multi-core processor or multiprocessor. Let's see one by one. The first type, that is a general purpose processor, that is GPP. GPP, that is general purpose processor, is a general purpose processor with an instruction set designed not specific to the application, that is called general purpose processor. that is a microprocessor in addition with embedded processor. Then second type, application specific instruction set processor, that is ASIP. And ASIP is a processor with an instruction set designed for specific application on a VLSI chip. Here examples, microcontroller, embedded microcontroller, then digital signal processor, that is a DSP, and media processor, network processor, IO processor, or domain specific programmable processor. So these are the examples of application specific instruction set processor. Then third type, that is a single purpose processor as additional processor. So here examples, coprocessor, accelerator, controller. Okay, name itself, it is a single purpose, but additional processor also used. Okay, then fourth type, that is GPP or ASIP. These codes integrated into either ASIC or VLSI circuit or a fixed programmable gate array core integrated with the processor units in a VLSI chip, that is ASIC chip. The next one, application specific system processor, that is ASSP. Then last one, multi-core processor or multiprocessor. So application specific system processor means for specific application embedded system can be used for that. So that type is called as application specific system processor. Then multi-core processor or multiprocessor means the embedded system may be used for many applications, that is called multi-core processor or multiprocessor. Okay, so these are the types of processors. Then the next slide shows selection of processor. That is, during selection of processor, some important points are considered. They are instruction set, processor size, then processor speed, and processor ability. Okay, first let's see the first one, that is the instruction set. So instruction set may be either RISC processor or CISC processor. Okay, so that is called instruction set. Then processor size. So processor size means a maximum bit of an operand value. That is a 8-bit processor or 16-bit processor or 32-bit, like that. Okay, then processor speed. So processor speed is nothing but clock frequency in megahertz. Okay, that is a processing speed in million instructions per second. That is MIPS, million instructions per second. Then fourth one, processor ability. So processor ability means to solve complex algorithm while meeting deadline for the processing. So during selection, so these points are considered. Here, a microprocessor or general purpose processor is used because of the following reasons. The first one, that is a processing based on the instruction available in a predefined general purpose instruction set, result in quick system development. Once the board and input or output interfaces are designed for general purpose processor, these can be used for a new system by just changing the embedded system software in the ROM chip. Then ready availability of a compiler facilities embedded software development in high level languages. Then ready availability of well tested and debugged processor specific application program interfaces, that is ASIS, and codes previously designed for other applications, result in advanced new system are developed quickly. Okay, so these are the points we have considered during selection of processor. So in this video, we learned classification of embedded system, then processor in an embedded system, then types of embedded system, then selection of processor. We will see in the next video. Thank you.